Matter is all around us. Anything and everything in the universe we observe today is made of matter. More specifically, protons, neutrons, and electrons. But if our universe was created from Big Bang, there should be same amount of antimatter in the universe. But sadly, it has not been found in large amount yet. So where did it go? Matter is made up of fundamental particles like protons, neutrons, and electrons. Protons are positively charged and heavy particles, neutrons are chargeless but heavy, and electrons are negatively charged and light particles. Now, antimatter is made of the antiparticles of these fundamental particles. Take hydrogen for example. One electron is orbiting one proton. For an antihydrogen atom, a positron orbits around an antiproton. As we know, protons and neutrons are made of quarks. Similarly, their antiparticles are made of antiquarks. If matter and antimatter collide, they annihilate each other, releasing large amount of energy in terms of gamma rays. The antimatter theory was first brought to light by Paul Dirac in 1928. He was studying the relativistic effects of Schrödinger equation, which had resulted into the prediction of anti-electrons. His prediction was confirmed when Anderson in 1932 first detected positrons in bubble chamber. Now, labs like CERN produce positrons in sufficient amounts. There is a significant use of antimatter. In medical science, positron emission tomography or PET scans are done using positrons. There is no intrinsic difference between particles and antiparticles. They appear on essentially the same footing in all particle theories. This means that the laws of physics for antiparticles are almost identical to those for particles. It can be told from the CPT symmetry. We will discuss CPT symmetry later in detail. But for now, it means if you interchange particles for antiparticles, look in a three-dimensional mirror and reverse time, you cannot tell the difference between them. But there certainly is a dramatic difference in the numbers of these objects we find in the world around us. All of the world is made of matter. Any antimatter we produce in the labs soon disappears because it meets up with matching matter particles and annihilates. The dominance of matter in our universe was discovered by many experiments. Results from high-energy antimatter telescope as well as data from the alpha magnetic spectrometer support the matter dominance in our universe. Most objects observable from Earth seems to be made of matter rather than antimatter. If antimatter dominated regions of space existed, the gamma rays produced in annihilation reactions along the boundary between matter and antimatter regions would be detectable. Now, observation from NASA's Fermi Gamma Ray Space Telescope discovered that thunderstorm makes antimatter, but in small amount, in our atmosphere. But if matter and antimatter are symmetrical, then why is there matter dominance in our universe? It is hypothesized that after Big Bang, during the period of baryogenesis, the universe was extremely hot and dense. Matter and antimatter were continually produced and annihilated during this time. The presence of remaining matter and absence of detectable remaining antimatter is called baryon asymmetry. The exact mechanism which provided this asymmetry during baryogenesis remains an unsolved problem. One of the necessary conditions for this asymmetry is the violation of CP symmetry, which has been experimentally observed in weak interaction. But till now, it remains as an unsolved problem in physics. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video. If you want to see such videos in future, please subscribe.